of Jungle Jim. The adventures of Jungle Jim, broadcast weekly over this station, are dramatized from the full-color action pictures to be found in the Comic Weekly, the world's greatest comic supplement that comes to you each week with your Hearst Sunday newspaper. Join the 11 million adults and the 6 million youngsters who enjoy the world's best artists featured in every issue of the Comic Weekly, which comes to you with your Hearst Sunday newspaper. Just when the attacking force of Marines were ready to rush the strongly entrenched position of native guards on Thorson's Island, an earth-shattering roar was heard as the entire castle was blown to dust by a time fuse in the powder magazine set by Thorson himself. Jungle Jim's task seems to be ended, but he had a hunch that Thorson might attempt to escape in the one submarine left in the underground harbor. The authorities put at his disposal a speedy patrol boat, and the hunt for the submarine is on.
Well, Jim, there's a periscope showing. These deep sea eggs we carry are mighty effective in bringing subs to the surface.
Well, it's the one of the force of the explosion doesn't crush in their sides.
Nah, that seldom happens. Just a few plates, a stove in, a few seams open. Then it either comes to the surface at once or stays down forever.
Well, they're not coming up any further, are they?
They're just up to take a peek at us through the periscope. Maybe they'd like to see if they can pot us with a torpedo. I'll show them a new trick. Depth charge.
Ready, sir.
Set for 40 feet. Hold on, Jim. Got to open up their engines.
Set for 40 feet. It is, sir.
Release. Depth charge. 40 feet.
Depth charge. 40 feet. Ready, sir.
Release. Depth charge, 30 feet.
Depth charge, 30 feet, ready.
Release.
Say, aren't those things liable to tip us over? I can feel our boat jump up every time one goes off.
This PT is built to take it. Depth bombs can't do us much harm. Not as much as they can that sub.
Well, there's your answer. It's almost stopped moving. Coming up to the surface.
Now we'll get to the bottom of this. You recognize her?
Well, she's either the one that shelled us aboard Kennedy's schooner or a reasonably exact facsimile. And I'll bet my hat it's the same identical one.
Man the machine gun, Halton. Give it a test to make sure it's in order.
Aye, aye, sir.
Well, that works okay. But I hope we won't have to use it.
Me too. Just in case, I'm going to move up on him now.
Oh, there comes the cover of the conning tower. The after deck hatch, too.
Hi there. What ship are you?
What is the reason for this attack? You have damaged my ship. We are in a dangerous condition.
Just a minute, we'll be right over. Recognize this fellow, Jim?
Boy, I'll swear in a stack of Bibles this high. I know him and that voice very well.
Okay, pal. Stow that gab and line your whole crew topside, mister, and be smart about it.
You will pay for this. Even your government has not the power to destroy shipping on the high seas and endanger the lives of my crew.
You're a great one to try that line. Get your crew up there. We'll board you and bring them up faster.
Remember, I am doing this under protest. We are using armed force.
I know what I'm using and how to deal with your kind of pirate.
Thorson's not among that bunch yet.
You have another gentleman aboard. Sort of last-minute passenger. Get him up, too.
All the members of my crew are present and accounted for.
Think he's bluffing, Jim?
I'm positive of it. Let me board him. I'll find Thorson.
Wait. Wait till I try one more tack on him. Man the gun.
Aye, aye, sir.
If Thorson doesn't come up out of there before I count 10, we'll begin target practice. One. Two.
Ready, sir.
Three. Four.
Wait, don't shoot. He will come up. I promise that.
I thought you'd understand, Captain.
You two men, go down and bring him up. If necessary, use force.
No need to send anybody after me. Here I am.
Will Thorson, in the name of the government of the United States, you are under arrest.
And in the name of Bull Thorson, you'll never live to tell it.
Hold on. We gotta get going.
A magazine blew up.
Seems to be Thorson's favorite trick.
I suppose so. And this time, his last.
That was the end of Thorson. His friendship, though, was even more dangerous than its enmity. For as he went down to defeat by Jungle Jim, he dragged scores more to a watery grave beside his own. Jim returns to Lil and Kitty now aboard the cruiser to find that Kolu, though weak, is well on the road to recovery. In Puerto Rico for a week's rest and relaxation, Jim realizes that there will always be the elements of friction and rivalry between the girls, Lil and Kitty. Not wanting to hurt either, Jim sends each one a letter, which seems to be the best way out of a mixed-up situation. Lil has just received hers.
Well, I wonder what's up now. It's from Jim, all right. Dear Lil, I know you will understand both my motive and reasoning in making such a difficult decision as the one I'm faced with, and the necessity of informing you of it in this manner. I can't even hint at my destination, but it's another case. And circumstances this time force me to play a lone hand. We'll write regularly, Jim. Circumstances, bah! Why, you know as well as I do, Jim Bradley, that circumstances in this case are cute and blonde and dumb and named Kitty St. John. Oh. Why am I afflicted with such people? Why didn't I poison that dame when we met? Well, it's too late for that. But it's not too late for me to tell her what I really think of her.
Who's there?
Senorita St. John, I have for you a letter. It is marked very personal, important to you. Here you are, Senorita.
Oh, just a moment. There, thank you.
Oh. Gracias, señorita. Gracias.
It's from Jim. His first letter to me. Dear Kitty, I know you will understand both my motive and reasoning in making such a difficult decision as the one I am faced with, and the necessity of informing you of it in this manner. I can't even hint at my destination, and circumstances force me to play a lone hand. Why don't you find a nice, substantial businessman and be happy as I will be knowing that you are? Goodbye, Jim. Goodbye. Why, of all the ungrateful creatures, find a nice, substantial businessman. Where does he think they grow on, trees? Be happy. Oh, well, I can see the fine Italian hand of one Shanghai Lil in this little billet-doux. Shanghai Lil. There's one person I could cheerfully kill. Why do some people live so long anyway? She can't get away with this. Not on me, she won't. I'll fight her tooth and nail, and I'll beat her at her own game. No, Jim Bradley, it's not goodbye till I've had a showdown with that Lily DeVril.
Here. I really didn't expect to find you at all.
Well, I expected to find you and didn't expect to stop till I did.
Isn't that interesting? We both had the same idea. May I come in?
I'd be delighted, Miss DeVril. Come in. Well?
All right. Let's put all the cards on the table, Kitty St. John. Why don't you go away and leave Jim and me alone?
Don't you think that such a suggestion, so long as it doesn't concern you only, should also come from the other party?
Now, I'm not going to bandy words with you, but you've been a nuisance ever since Jim and I saved your life out at Tony Lowry's plantation. And as far as I'm concerned, it was one job we fumbled. You've been in our hair ever since.
That's just the sort of half-truth to be expected from one of your sort. Again, let me remind you, your opinion is of less importance to me than Jim Bradley's. I can't help it if he prefers me.
prefers you.
That's a laugh. Don't mistake a gentleman's sympathy for the grand passion, my dear.
I don't make such mistakes. Few women do make them till they pass a certain age.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, you're no schoolgirl, and as one grows older, the foolish notion that they have fatal fascination for all men clouds up any judgment they might have.
Now, my age is my business, and my judgment has carried me a long way.
In all those years, it should have. Well, now it's going the wrong way.
Why, you fishwife.
The only way you'll be any kind of a wife is if someone marries you for your money. Well, even then, they'll be stuck.
I came here to give you some good advice, but you're too smart to take it now. Well, I'm going to give you something else, something your parents neglected.
What? There's my answer, you jealous old cat.
You little brat, I'll show you. Wait.
You will you?
I certainly will show you.
You.
You got this knife. What else can I expect from such riffraff?
You can expect this.
Hey.
Now, look here.
Open the door.
I'm going to pull every hair out of your head.
Oh, no, you're not.
Yes, I am. Is that what you think? Get away from
your door!
Get away from me, kitty
thing! Oh, I say, what the... Oh, stop it. Stop it this minute. Have you two run amok?
Tony, your face is cut.
Well, is that surprising? This is the most unusual reception I've ever had. In more ways than one.
Oh, here, let me fix it, Tony.
What?
Oh, you poor boy. It was an accident. Get some water, Lil. Don't you see he's hurt?
Just a minute. What's been going on here, anyway?
Now, don't ask too many questions, Tony. We were just having a little discussion.
A discussion? I hope I never see an argument.
Now, Tony, don't be sarcastic. Here, let me put a bandage on. It's only a scratch, anyway.
Well, for goodness sake.
Yes, see? Now it's fixed. Oh, Tony, I'm so glad to see you. Where have you been? You haven't written or anything.
I haven't written. Well, after a dozen of my letters came back, that's when I started out to look for you.
Look for me?
I've come halfway around the world to find that you were down here, Kitty. I've traveled 10,000 miles to see you and ask you one question.
Say, you two, this is where I came in. I'm leaving.
Don't go, Lil. We've been such good friends together for such a long time. I want you two to hear the answer from Kitty's lips she's already given me with her eyes.
Well, thanks, Tony, but I think I'll go now.
Wait a second, Lil. What is it, Tony?
I want you to come back with me, Kitty, as Mrs. Lowry.
Tony, I will.
Well, congratulations to you both.
Say.
The best of good luck.
Thanks, Kitty.
So long.
Thanks, Willie.
Well, Lil, it all comes out in the wash.
Yeah, but can you get a shirt without a ticket? Well, she's got her man. Now for mine. Jungle Jim Bradley, here I come.
Don't miss the next exciting episode in the adventures of Jungle Jim. Remember, you can follow these adventures in the full-color action pictures to be found in the Comic Weekly, the world's greatest comic supplement containing the best full-color adventure and comic pictures. Remember, no other comic supplement can give you the top names of cartoon land like the all-star favorites to be found in the Comic Weekly. Why, the whole family follows the fun and frolics of Jiggs and Maggie, the Little King, the immortal Donald Duck, as well as the exciting adventures of Jungle Jim and Flash Gordon. Join the 11 million adults and the 6 million youngsters who every week find the greatest of home entertainment in the Comic Weekly, which comes to you with your Hearst Sunday newspaper.